it! This is a rat attack! Who's go? Who's just about to have a throw?
Ever heard of the game Nightmare? It's a lot like the other games in the 90s. It came with a VHS and you'd time it with your play, and the character in the video would give you instructions on what to do while you played the game in real time. And me being a scaredy cat back then, I refused to play it when my mom bought it for us. My brother was disappointed about not being able to play Nightmare, but my mom had a solution to this. She brought out Rap Rat. It was a cheap, dingy little thing, and it catered to kids more my age, and you basically went around the board and collected cheese, and the first player to reach the end would win, and it seemed simple enough, and it kinda reminded us of Mousetrap, which we didn't have, so there was honestly no objections. We popped the movie into the VHS and set up the board, and as the first part of the video was just a simple explanation of the rules as well as the instructions and how the game worked. Then Rap Rat came onto the TV, and he was not what any of us had been expecting. My smaller brother, who was only 3 at the time, immediately left the room crying. The ears were just far too big, and it had a mouth that was lined with 2 teeth, and the insides of the mouth almost looked swollen, and the most striking part about the whole thing, though, was the eyes. They were large, glossy, and almost fish-like. I first asked, then bothered, and then begged my mom to turn it off, and Rap Rat suddenly shouted loudly, screaming, wailing, saying, "Wait your turn!" in a demonic, low-pitched voice that was not at all like his obnoxious nasal voice. In the background, you could hear the narrator saying, "He's Rap Rat, and he's the boss," over and over again in an overly serious tone. The video was indescribable. Images crossed the screen in a quick succession, overcut with Rap Rat's expressionless eyes. The images were some of the things I was afraid of at the time: a person looking over a balcony, a hornet slowly stinging somebody in the eye, an extreme close-up of a tarantula, a pit full of writhing cobras, and a bloodied syringe filled with a green fluid. We immediately turned off the video, and I ran out of the room screaming, slamming my door. It took my mom about 20 minutes to convince me that the video was gone and that I would never have to see it again. I had nightmares all week about Rap Rat. Unfortunately, that wasn't the last time I saw Rap Rat. While my girlfriend and I were preparing to move in together, I was cleaning the closet of my room and I found Rap Rat once again. With the same VHS and the same board game inside, it was almost perfectly intact, save for a thick layer of cobwebs and dust bunnies on top of it. This was strange. Didn't my mother get rid of it? And what was the game doing in my room? I let out of a bit of a gasp when I found it, and my girlfriend came in the room asking me what was the matter. Breathing harshly, I said, "Rap Rat." She laughed a bit, asking me if it was a joke, and I shook my head, explaining to her that it wasn't, and she didn't believe me. Nobody did, so I decided that the only way to prove it was to show her the video. I borrowed my neighbor's VHS and I played the video for her. However, the images had changed. I saw a clown and its nose bursted, spraying blood all over the screen, and I saw a woman alone in a dark room. I saw a man being forced to pick up a white hot metal and hold it into his outstretched hand, turning his hand into a leathery mess. The scratching I heard as a child continued and picked up louder and louder, and then Rap Rat showed up and began twisting and convulsing his arms, thrusting this way and that. The costume wasn't even a costume anymore. The felt was real fur. Its face was no longer plastic, but instead a bristle of thorns with teeth. The eyes turned inward and suddenly popped out again. Rap Rat's huge fish eyes were inside out, staring right at me, watching my every move, my every expression. It grinned widely and it gestured to my girlfriend, and with a single, outstretched, inhuman hand, I could hear the faintest of scratching at my front door. The TV went blank and showed static. The scratching got louder and louder, eventually turning into thumping, thumping of tiny feet on the wood of my door. My girlfriend embraced me in fears and my senses kicked in. Before anything else could happen, I stopped the video and I ejected it, unplugged the VHS. The scratching stopped. When I finally got the courage to go to my living room window, nothing was there. Shortly after, we heard another knock at the door. However, this time it was the police. Apparently, a neighbor had seen a figure outside of our door and had called in concern. My girlfriend and I simply could not explain what happened. We had to tell the police officers that we did it, and I was furious that a children's game was terrifying me. I went to go pick up the tape, but the VHS burned my hand. It felt like I had touched a Bunsen burner on the highest setting. We had to get the oven mitts from the kitchen just to take it out. Even then, it was scorching hot, so I tossed it on the sidewalk and crushed it underneath my winter boots. My girlfriend and I had nightmares every night. We would both wake up in the middle of the night and describe eerily similar images that we saw in our sleep. The scratching would always be there at night, when the lights were off and the room was pitch black, save for the moonlight that was coming in through the window. Now, the scratching would happen every time I went near the front door, and every time we said Rap Rat's name. It sounded as if something very small was dragging something across the ground outside the door, pacing and waiting. I would simply wait and pull the covers up to my neck until I eventually succumbed to exhaustion. At this point, I was determined to sue the company for damages. The first thing I thought was to call up my mother and ask her where she got Rap Rat. She honestly had no idea. I found a merchant who sold the versions of Rap Rat and asked them how I could get in touch with the company. He sent me this email. I don't know much about the game, but I know it was created by the same people who created Nightmare. The company is called A Couple of Cowboys. Try them. So with that new lead, I decided to do a bit more research, and I discovered that the company became defunct in 1994, only 2 years after the company had created Rap Rat. I discovered why they did soon after. So in 1992, a year into the game's development, a couple of cowboys had commissioned a manufacturing company in Haiti to create the doll portrayed in the video game. The company who created the puppet ran a sweatshop, where they forced women and children to produce various components of the puppet, including the felt and the plastic of the doll. One day, a young Haitian girl got her arm caught in the industrial sewing machine. The spring loader, unable to handle the weight of the machine, came loose and struck the child in the neck, killing her instantly. A few days later, after the funeral, the mother of the child came into the factory demanding to see the owner, who denied that he had anything to do with it. In a fit of rage, the mother said that the blood of the innocent would seep into every crevice of the doll, every component in which it was created, and all who touched it would die. She claimed that she had summoned a fear demon and screamed at the top of her lungs, "Ap Rat will curse you." The owner simply laughed and told his corporate bosses about Ap Rat, and they spread the joke from person to person, and the game got renamed to Rap Rat, a loose anagram of Ap Rat, and each reincitation of the name of Ap Rat brought in a greater and greater curse. It was only 2 years after Rap Rat was created that the company shut down and the owners hired by Mattel. There were stories of workers begging for days off and even skipping work for weeks and weeks. Finding the puppet in strange places sooner were even stories of suicide, grim and violent suicides in which the workers would stab their hands and burn themselves to death, writing, "I am fear," on the nearest surface in blood. Nobody really knows where the Rap Rat doll went after the original creators disappeared. Some say that the last things the victim saw before going insane were a large, sunken, fish-like eyes. And I kind of have a few words of warning. Never, ever say Ap Rat out loud. Saying a demon's name out loud is an invitation to them, a calling. If you have done this already, it cannot be undone. Do not try to speak or contact Ap Rat. Avoid being awake between 3:30 a.m. and 4 a.m. when Rap Rat is most likely to try and scare you. So the VHS is back, and I thought I stomped on it. I thought I smashed it to Kingdom Come, but it's back. I found it in my sock drawer yesterday. This time I was ready. a whole bunch of people been trying to contact me, trying to get the tape or some sort of video from the board game. My answer to you is just, it's too dangerous. If I did that, if I could tell you, it will very well drive you insane, scare you to death even. The video and the game, Raprat itself has some sort of strange power. Raprat follows me everywhere I go. I see little shadows in every corner. I hear sounds coming from down the hallway when I'm the only one home. If Raprat is there, it will let you know, but it will never let you see it. Until it's too late, of course. A lot of people have been watching the normal video from the normal board game, and that's the thing. Raprat can be normal. It will trick you into thinking it's just a puppet, and then stalk you day and night.